we're using as broad of an eligibility as we can for the vaccine production that we have at each interval on the federal level. And we encourage the state to follow suit with the federal guidelines at these sites to avoid confusion. And that would then help to make sure we don't have different people being vaccinated and eligible at different sites.
The mayor in Orange County announced that teachers of any age, people in higher education, can get vaccinated. That's specifically what the governor's executive order does not say. He's saying on the local level, we want to try to come into line with the FEMA guidelines, so it's less confusing. Does Florida need a written down plan as it goes along, like most other states do?
So certainly we'd encourage them to either do that or just simply keep consistent with the federal guidelines. And we've seen pushback by Governor DeSantis on this. We applaud Mayor Demings. I saw that inconsistency firsthand that Mayor Demings is trying to correct. My wife is an educator. We woke up early on Sunday morning and waited online for an hour and a half at Valencia West for her to finally get her first vaccine since she first became eligible this past week. And we didn't go to the state sites because she's under 50 and under the governor's rules, she wouldn't be eligible. But some of her friends this weekend who are educators under 50 went to the convention center, a state site, and got vaccinated. So it's problematic because it's not fair to the teachers who were trying to go to other state sites and then ended up going to federal sites because they thought they weren't eligible when we want to have as many access points as possible. There is a solution to this. The governor can simply mirror the federal guidelines that we have in place to avoid these inconsistencies. And look, we're about to have $1.9 trillion in funding to finally fully defeat this virus, provide meaningful relief to the American people, including in Central Florida, and rebuild and recover. And so the feds, we're going to have the resources to scale this up as broad as possible, as quickly as possible. That's what these vaccine sites are about. FEMA knows how to scale up because they've dealt with disasters. Our National Guard that's participating, they know how to deal in these massive scales that it's going to take. We have to vaccinate the vast majority of 340 million Americans. As we look to children under 16, once the research supports that, we'll be vaccinating them as well. Otherwise, it would be all Americans that we'd want vaccinated. And so it's going to take these massive sites that we've stood up at Valencia West, these spoke sites, as we're talking about in my district, Poinciana, St. Cloud, Englewood. And so it helps to have consistent guidelines throughout so that we don't avoid this confusion and people being turned away when they'd be eligible at other sites.